Michael, good morning. It's Vance. Are you sleeping in? Clearly, because I answered my phone, no! My hoodoo's become tougher. We've achieved liftoff. We can easily beat Tangela. Well, thank God! You can beat something! You do, isn't that great? Let's talk later. I take back what I said about Vance. Whatever. Welcome back! The Pokemon Soul Silver Quest of the Chosen Six. We are in the middle of Ice Path. We've already completed everything here. So, I'm just gonna use some repels and get the heck out of here. Do I have any? Yes, I have 12 super repels. We're gonna use one. And now we're gonna run! I'm gonna fall down this hole. Cause screw going down ladders. Ladders are for chumps. And this is the one ice puzzle I don't think I've memorized how to do. I think. You never know. I'll figure it out. I got it. No, I don't. I don't have it. No, I didn't get it. I'll get it eventually. Here we go. Got it here. Okay. Now we found a full heal. That's great. Now I can fully heal things. So, yeah, we're still in the ice path, and do I really need Rock Smash to get that item? Stupid Rock Smash. I do need Rock Smash! That's so stupid! Whatever. I'll come back with an HM Slave, I guess. I guess. That's the one thing, in my opinion, about Pokemon games that they really... that is so freaking outdated that they really need to change. HMs. Because in the current generations, the only difference, literally the only difference between HMs and TMs is that HMs cannot be forgotten at any time. They can only be deleted by a move deleter. Every other, they're the exact same thing currently because TMs and HMs are both unlimited use in the current generations. So there is, and there are even lots of TMs that can be used outside of battle. Like Flash and Rock Smash. They used to be HMs, of course, but they're TMs now. So literally, the only, I think I pushed the boulder down too far. So yeah, currently, the only difference between them is you can't forget them. What? They need to do something about the stupid HMs in the next generation. They need to either remove them entirely, you know, make them all TMs, so they can be forgotten anytime, or remove them from the game entirely, and just make it like, if a Pokemon is able, like for example, let's say there's a tree in my way, and I have a Pokemon that has blades like Scyther or Hone Edge. There is no reason I shouldn't be able to cut that stupid tree just because they don't have the attack cut, you know? Or like a boulder. I'm pretty sure half my Pokemon know how to push a boulder. Gareth, you know, he's a fighting type. He can strong and stuff, and crap, my repel wore off. Let's put that repel back up. We don't want to deal with these deli birds swarming us with their presence. That was actually a pun without an... And I, oh, here's the kimono girl stuck in the ice. Kind of easy to free her. Me, oh my, is that you, Michael? Fancy meeting you here. Tell the truth, my sandals are frozen in the ice and I am stuck here. Whereas my flip-flops are quick frozen with the ground. Tee? Well, it's no laughing matter. Would you push my back? Yes. Physics. She gets pushed forward and she's the one stuck. And I'm not stuck and I stay in one place. Physics, everybody. Physics. I'd like to get on a physics rant here, but I'd rather not. About how I should have been the one pushed back, not her, if she was really so stuck. But whatever. We freed her. Now we can continue with our adventure if I can figure out how to get back to the point that I was at. I don't think I can. Wait. I'll get it. Yeah, I got it. Yay! And we are now in Blackthorn City. The final city of Johto. Well, you came to the ice path? You must be a real hotshot trainer. You came to the ice path? You must be a real hotshot trainer. Sounds different when you're sending in a condescending way. The ice path isn't that hard. Anyway, yeah, I'm going to heal now. And I can heal before I start the gym. Once I start the gym, then the rules come into effect. The gym is the only part of this town that has trainers, and so there's no Pokemon here, so... Yeah, and unlike before when I said I was overleveled, Claire's best is at level 41, so hopefully I actually gain some levels during the gym. Before I do anything, let me see what the dice rule is going to be to see if I should stock on items or whatever. Save the game, I'm going to go to the camera mode. Alright, here is the die for Blackthorn City Gym and the city in its entirety. It is a 6! Oh, great. Oh. Well, we may actually lose this challenge, guys. So, you know what 6 is? No switching Pokemon during battle. Basically, whoever starts a battle must finish it, unless they faint, in which case they're dead, and can't be used for the rest of the route. So, every Pokemon that starts the battle will be the one who has to finish the battle. Or die. That's that. Let's go. Alright, we need to plan this accordingly. This is a dragon gym. At the time of this game coming out, the only Pokemon they're going to use in this gym, spoilers, are Dratinis, Dragonairs, Horsies, and Seadras. So, basically, I gotta make sure I use Raijin against the people that are using Horsies and Seadras, and I gotta use Holly against the Pokemon that are using the Dragons. But I'm gonna look in my bag right now to see if there's any Ice-type moves that I can teach people. And I've got nothing. Nothing at all. Nothing. Nothing. Absolutely nothing. So this ought to be fun. Oh yeah, I guess Omnidita could also handle the Horsies and Seadra people. But I think it'd be cheating to look things up. So, this is gonna suck. I'm not looking forward to this at all. Alright, so. See, if I start with Holly, this is the gym I get Dragon Pulse. I wish I had Dragon Pulse now. But yeah, I'm gonna start off with Holly for these battles. If it's a Dragon Pokemon, great. I'll just kill it with an Ice Beam. If it's a Horsea or Seadra, it's gonna be a long, long battle of just back and forth water attacks. Unless I look things up, but that would be cheating. But I've brought up Ballipedia millions of times during this playthrough just to make sure I'm fighting and catching everything. So maybe it wouldn't be totally cheating to know what trainer's gonna have what Pokemon. All right, I just happened to look at Ballipedia just to make sure I'm fighting the right amount of trainers, and yes, there are 6 trainers here. Unfortunately, I have a problem with the whole check which one's gonna use which. This guy uses both. He's going to have 2 Dratinis and a Seadra. So, yeah. And also, I don't know what order Ballipedia threw the trainers in. So I'm just going to have to go with my best guess here. I'm definitely... See, now we're evenly matched with the opponent's levels. So I'm not overleveled anymore. So, glad I didn't do any training. See, that's why it's so weird, the level curve in this game. You saw the route we were just on. They were in, like, the mid to late 20s, those trainers Pokemon. And now in this gym, they're suddenly in the mid to upper 30s, and the gym leader's gonna be 41. So, I don't know, it's weird. I guess I don't know. But see, here's Seadra. I can't switch. So we're just gonna have to sit here and fight it. Honestly, I think Surf is stronger than Twister, despite it being not very effective. I'll prove it to you. Here's how much Surf does. Oh, I won't be able to prove anything, because it does over half. I'm still going to use Surf twice in a row. So yeah, and also I am allowed to heal via Pokemon Center, so I can leave and heal anybody. But if they died, of course, then they're still not going to be used for the remainder of the route. That's something I don't think was clear. Because I did say you can heal Pokemon via Pokemon Center. And I'm allowed to go to the Pokemon Center if it's within the area. And this is the Blackthorn City area, so I'm allowed to use the Pokemon Center at any time. But if a Pokemon dies in the area, they still can't be used, even if I go to the Pokemon Center in the area. They can't be healed until the area is complete. So I don't know if that rule was ever made clear, but now I'm making it clear. I also should probably buy more healing items. These 17 lemonades should do me well for now. And I also have 12... I thought it said 12. No, I only have 3 hyper potions. Well, good thing there's a mart within the area that I can stock up on before the gym leader. And I'm definitely going to need items because, you know, I'm going to only rely on one Pokemon at a time during this gym. And for this next person, assuming I'm going the right order, I should still keep Hylia up front. Dragons are sacred Pokemon. They have a life energy. If you're not serious, you'll be able to beat them. Me not be serious about the games I play? Pfft. Oh, you silly person. Alright, Holly. Also, I'm definitely going to have to go to the Pokemon Center to heal up on the, you know, restore my ice beams and stuff. Because they only have 10 PP, and yeah. It's going to be the move I'm going to be using this whole gym, basically. Also, I don't know what the heck I'm going to do against Clair's Kingdra. That thing has caused me problems every single time I've played through Soul Silver. Every single time. Okay, maybe not every single time, but... She, in my opinion, is notorious for being... She is... I don't know if it's the same for you. In my personal experience, she is the hardest gym leader for me. I'm sure it's different for other people. I hear Whitney's Miltank is hard for a lot of people. Never... It hasn't always... It really hasn't for me, though. It's always been Clair's Kingdra. Because its only weakness is dragon. And what are the odds you have a dragon type at this point in the game? Zero. I guess I don't know how this thing works. Oh, it turns that way. What a stupid way to turn it. No, I shouldn't have turned it! I should not have turned it! I immediately regret this decision. Or do I? Never mind, that was what I was supposed to do. Or I did it completely backwards, it just happened to work anyway. Whatever the case may be. On the other side. I think this person has a Horsey and Seedra. I'm sorry if this is cheap to you guys that I'm looking this up, but I've always been looking things up. I just haven't necessarily been doing it for which trainers have which Pokemon. I'm doing it because I want to have my full team for Clair. So, well, not necessarily the full team. I want to have the Pokemon that are going to be staples in the battle. Like, I cannot afford to lose Raijin because she has a Gyarados. Pretty sure that's who she starts with. And then she has her 2 Dragonairs, which I'm going to have to use Holly against. But Raijin's going to have to stay in and die. So hopefully he can do some damage until that happens. So that's my logic behind this. And yay, defeated Cody. Alright, now, this next trainer, I didn't change around my Pokemon. I hope this person has a Seedra. I think she does. Okay, good, she does. Hooray! You know, we might don't even actually have to go back to the Pokemon Center. Because after this, there's only one more trainer, and he has a Dragonair, so Holly can probably take care of that. And yay, level for Raijin. Oh, that's disappointing. Oh, so disappointing. Alright, let us go switch to Holly again. And this is the last trainer. Before Clair, of course. My chance of losing not even 1%. Oh, you may want to recalculate your odds there. Seeing as you only have 1 Pokemon, and I have 6, all of which were chosen. Har 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 har. I'm so funny. I should heal anyway. Ice Beam only has 5 more PP. I'm probably gonna need to use it more times than that. It won't take long to go heal and stuff, so that's what I'm gonna do. Dragon Rage. That only does 40 damage! Every time. Which is helpful, of course, but... yeah. And yeah, that's the end of Mike. That's odd. I know where you're going. Thanks for showing me. Oh, you are welcome, good sir. With such an awkwardly odd name. I couldn't imagine anyone having that weird of a name. So yeah, I'm gonna go heal now. Be back soon! Alright, time for the final spinny block puzzle. I think I'm doing it wrong. No! That's not what I wanted to do! Not at all. This is what I wanted to do. I think this is what I want to do. Yes, this is what I want to do. All right, Claire. We meet again for however the heck many times I've played through Soul Silver. Which is a lot. Not nearly as many as Black and White, though. Just a small fun fact. I am Claire, the world's best Dragon-type master. Wow. Starting this off with a lie, are we? Because, you know, the champion of this region is kind of a dragon trainer, and yet... you're just the 8th gym leader. So yeah, Gyarados is who she starts with. And I have a shiny Gyarados. So yeah, I don't know, that's cool or something. So yeah, Gyarados shouldn't be a problem because of Raijin. Right? Right? Right?
Yes!
Alright, now she just has her two Dragonairs and Kingdra. And she sent out one of the Dragonairs. Alright. Raijin's gonna just have to do as much as he can until he dies. So let's start off with a Thunder Wave! Because why not? It's paralyzed. What? How can you paralyze a... It has sheds... Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Oh, boy. Oh boy, Raijin. Are you in for a treat? Well, probably should have just went with two Thunderbolts instead of the Thunder Wave, but whatever. Yeah, because with two Thunderbolts, I easily could have put it in range of being able to be killed with a Holly's Ice Beam. Ooh! Raijin! Taking it like a man! Oh, I almost want to heal you now and let you handle the rest of this battle, but... I don't know about... You've done your part, man. You've... Awesome, that was great. Holly's definitely able to kill it now. Nice job, Raijin. You get a salute as you go down. Alright, let us see. Now it is time for Holly to finish it off. Although, I'm just really, really hoping she doesn't use her own Kingdra after... after I kill this Dragonair. Because I need someone else to kill Kingdra, but Holly's the one I want to kill the other Dragonair. So... Alright, yay, Holly's 37. Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo. And Dragon... Yes! Thank you, Claire! Thank you for playing right into my trap! Alright, I'm not sure... It's kind of a higher level, and its move kind of gets stabbed, so... It's frozen! It's not frozen anymore, but that's okay, because it's gonna die. Oh, that was just too perfect! That was just too perfect. Fantastic job, Holly. Time for a Kingdra battle! Except hers is probably going to win, because she has Dragon Pulse, and I have Twister. And she's a higher leveled. So, Holly, you did a fantastic job. I appreciate all your hard work. Oh, come on! One hit KO! Oh. Alright, well. Who shall I use next? I'm gonna go with Amanita. Let us go with Spore. Uh-oh, wait a second. Oh no. Hang in there, Amanita! Yes! Alright! Alright. Alright, this is gonna be a stall fest. Because I'm gonna have to basically heal after every turn. Or else she's gonna kill me. And she's gonna kill me anyway with a critical hit, so... But here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna heal. She's gonna at least be asleep this turn, for sure. Yes. She could easily wake up this next turn, though. We're gonna go with Leech Seed, though. Yes, she didn't wake up! Leech Seed! Why did I know you were gonna miss, Amanita? I just knew, for some reason. As soon as I use it, I knew you were gonna miss. Whatever, Leech Seed always wins. We win. I don't know if Amanita, you'll be the one to... For Kingdra to die, like, you'll be the one who's out when Kingdra dies, but we got this. Basically, if you happen to die, if Amanita happens to die, my plan is to send in Gareth, because he has super high special defense, so he should be able to tank hits from this Kingdra. And we have to heal, oh, great. It's not asleep, and it goes first. So, I have a couple choices here. Either heal... Keep healing and let Leech Seed do the work. Or let Amanita die and have Gareth finish it off. Okay. Let's go with Mach Punch. Oh, that did hardly anything. It used Hydro Pump. That was kind of a risky move going for that. But whatever. Alright, Gareth, you're up. And Gareth also has Drain Punch, so he should be just fine. You're kidding, right? I'm supposed to win! I already decided! Oh, I hate her so much. Did I mention that? I did say she's a gym leader I have the hardest time with, but I also hate her. For more reasons than one. And yay, critical hit didn't need it. If it wasn't a critical hit, at least she would have finished it off. Guarantee it. Nice teamwork, everybody. That was a great battle. I don't believe it. There must be some mistake. See, she's such a word that I don't like saying in my videos. Go, have you really lost your lazy ideal? See, she's just such an idiot. Such an ignorant idiot. An ignorant idiot. What do you want, Erwin? I heard about your heroic liberation of the radio tower. You rock so hard. I just want to make sure you knew that you're awesome. Call you later. Thank you, Erwin. What a way to boost the spirits, but by then calling someone saying you're awesome. That's why I have him in my number. Also because he's a creeper. He knows about my adventure, even though I don't tell anyone. Although liberating the radio tower, that was a long time ago. I know you guys just saw it kind of recently, but that was a long time ago. That was a whole sleepwalk ago, actually. All right, well, Daktar is severely behind in levels, so he really needs to be up front. So yeah, the next area is the Dragon's Den, and we're going to start it for a little bit, and then we're going to stop the episode there. Dragon's Den shouldn't be too hard, though. Although, it is in need of... Are there any Pokemon in Blackthorn? Probably not. I would have noticed it if there was. Alright, Dragon's Den. This does require a dice roll, so I'll be right back. Alright, Dragon's Den. What is the number for Dragon's Den? It is... 4! 4. Oh no! I can't use the Pokemon Center in Dragon's Den? Oh, the horror! Alright, basically, there isn't an additional challenge to Dragon's Den, because... Spoilers, it doesn't have a Pokemon Center. So yeah, there's only 3 trainers in here, too. But if I remember correctly, they're not easy. I always remember having trouble with them, but whatever, we'll do whatever we have to do. You, how dare you enter uninvited? What, are all minions of Clair idiots or something? I'm gonna guess what. His name was Kobe. Alright, we're gonna fly up high in the sky, so very high, to make Dragonair die. Oh, you! You poop head! You Grimer and Muckhead! Oh, you massively large pile of muck! It's like he knew I was gonna use Fly. Alright, Gareth, you finish it off! Well, Dactar can't be used the rest of the area. That kind of sucks a lot. Hey, random question for you all. As you know, as of 6th gen, there's Mega Evolutions. 3 of the chosen 6 have Mega Evolutions. Raijin, Pian Dao, and Dactar all have Mega Evolutions. If you owned this team, who would you have Mega Evolve? Because you could only have one Mega Evolver. Who would you have? I'm debating between Raijin and Dactar. Because personally, I think Scizor is good enough on his own. He doesn't need to have a Mega Evolution. Are there any trainers over here? There's an item over here. See, I'm debating between Raijin and Dactar. Let me know what you guys think, because I'm kind of trying to remake this team in my X version to use in Wi-Fi battles. I'm just curious which one I should make the Mega Evolver on the team. So yeah, Raijin or Dactar are the ones I'm debating between. So yeah, here's the next trainer. I, for some reason, think Almeida's a good idea. You shouldn't be in here. And what are you doing here that's so important? Standing there, staring at the wall? How productive!
Seed bomb.
By the way, guys, I've been meaning to replace Mach Punch with Focus Punch on Amanita for a long time. I got that TM from Chuck's gym. But I've noticed that Mach Punch has come in handy so many times. So for a while, I'm going to keep it. I don't know if I'm actually ever going to replace it with Focus Punch. Basically, I originally planned Amanita to be have a strategy where, you know, put it to sleep, then use Focus Punch. Because there's no reason I'd lose the focus if the opponent's asleep. So, that was a strategy in mind when I made Amanita, but Mach Punch is coming in more handy than I thought it would. So, this episode might run a little longer, but I'd like to at least fight the last trainer Dragon's Den before I continue. And that would be those little girls over there. And we're going to use Amanita and Gareth for this battle. The two originals to this team. It's a stranger, someone we don't know. Yes, that would be the definition of stranger. Thank you, little girls, for defining it. Klee and Jill. Dratini and Dratini! Hey, we're all evenly leveled. We're going to use Mach Punch and Psycho Cut on that one. See, look how much damage. I mean, it's just a Dratini. But see, Mach Punch is still doing a good enough damage for me to think it's good. And it's, you know, priority. So, 'tis a good move. And that is the end of the third and final trainer of Dragon's Den. So now all you have to do is catch the one and only Pokemon of the area, and then do the challenge of things. Whatever they're called. The sage who asks you questions. Crap, I need Whirlpool! Oh! Well, I do not want to teach it to Holly, because she's also going to have Waterfall. So I'm going to have to think about this for a little while. So yeah, I'm going to end the episode off here. Thank you all for watching this episode. I hope you enjoyed, and hope you look forward to the next episode, and whatever the heck else I'm gonna do with my YouTube crap. So yeah, thank you again for watching, and of course, Rock on!